Hello, I'm Warning Coordination Meteorologist Logan Johnson at the National Weather Service Office, San Francisco Bay Area, located in Monterey, California. This is a high-impact weather briefing update for the arrival of a series of Pacific storms expected to impact the San Francisco and Monterey Bay areas. Please do not use the information contained here after noon on Wednesday, November 28th, as it will be subject to change. The series of upcoming storm systems is expected to produce high-impact weather. A strong Pacific low pressure will move towards the area and bring a series of storm systems with significant rainfall over a few days, which will produce flooding concerns by this weekend. Winds will also increase late tonight from the south as the storm approaches and will be strong enough to produce some damage. Isolated thunderstorms will also accompany the storm system as it approaches tonight and Wednesday. These will be the greatest impacts, and we'll take a look at these in a little more detail. Significant rainfall is expected across the Bay Area over the next several days from a series of storm systems. Rainfall amounts will be heaviest in the high terrain and in the North Bay. Rainfall in excess of 12 inches over the next several days is possible in the favored westward-facing slopes of the high terrain. Important to note is the timing of these three storm systems. In between these three storm systems, only lighter rainfall is expected. The most significant rain will fall during these three storm systems. Lower elevations will see lower rainfall totals, but several inches are still expected. The lightest rain is expected in southeastern Monterey and San Benito counties far to the south, where only 1 to 3 inches will fall. With the significant rainfall, there will be flooding concerns as well. Small creeks and streams are expected to flood in favored locations, especially in the higher elevations. Rising water levels are expected on large rivers, especially in the North Bay, like the Russian and Napa rivers. The graphic here shows a forecast for the Russian River and the rises expected there. The pink line to the right shows the expected increase in water level on the river. Note that while it rises quickly, the current prediction is for the river to remain below flood stage. Additional urban flooding issues will be enhanced and complicated by tree debris like leaves and small branches that will fall and clog storm drains. There is also potential for landslides in high terrain as the ground becomes saturated on hillsides. South winds will increase late tonight and into Wednesday. Winds will be strongest over the waters and near the coast. High elevations will see strong winds as well. Winds will be a bit lighter across the inland valleys of the area, especially in the Santa Clara Valley and into Monterey and San Benito counties in the southern part of the area. Gusts of 65 miles per hour on the coast and along the ridgetops will be possible, and these can produce damage to downed trees and power lines. The highest wind gusts will come on Wednesday morning. Visit the link shown here for more information on current hazards. Marine impacts will be significant this week with the storm systems. Increasing winds by late Tuesday night should reach gale force at 35 to 40 knots with gusts to 50 knots. This will begin by Tuesday night and into the day on Wednesday. All of the local Pacific waters as well as the San Francisco and Monterey Bay waters will be in a gale warning for Tuesday night and Wednesday. In addition, we can expect some high seas over the Pacific as the strong winds will produce seas of 14 to 18 feet offshore. Thunderstorms will accompany the first storm system moving in late Tuesday night and Wednesday. Graphic here depicting where the greatest threat for thunderstorms will be late tonight and tomorrow morning. Storms can produce lightning and gusty winds across the area, which could enhance the damaging wind threat where storms do develop. Widespread severe weather is not expected. The next scheduled update will be on Wednesday as more information and more accurate details are available then. Unscheduled updates can occur if significant changes are expected to the forecast impacts. In the meantime, you should follow the National Weather Service San Francisco Bay Area on Twitter at NWS Bay Area. You can also follow us on Facebook. The easiest way to do that is to search for the U.S. National Weather Service San Francisco. You can always visit on the web at weather.gov/San Francisco. Please feel free to share your feedback, and as the storm arrives, we'd love to hear how it's impacting you and your rainfall amounts and wind gusts. Thank you for watching.